thermal expansion. From our experience, we know that substances expand on heating and contract on cooling. For example, a tightly screwed bottle with metallic lid has to put the lid in hot water to open the lid because expansion of metal is more than glass. Similarly, mercury in a thermometer rises when the thermometer is put in slightly warm water. A balloon partially inflated expands in hot water. So these experiments clearly confirms that there is thermal expansion when heat is applied in solid, liquid or gases. So what is thermal expansion? The increase in dimension of a body due to the increase in its temperature is called thermal expansion. There are three types of thermal expansion: linear expansion, area expansion and volume expansion. What is coefficient of linear expansion, which is denoted by alpha L? Consider a substance in the form of a long rod. Suppose the change in temperature is delta T. So what will be the fractional change in length? Suppose it is delta L divided by L, where L is the original length and delta L is the change in length. From experiment, it is found that the fractional change in length, that is delta L divided by L, is proportional to the change in temperature, delta T. So delta L divided by L will be equal to alpha L into delta T. Here alpha L is a constant which is called coefficient of linear expansion. In this table, the magnitude of coefficient of linear expansion of some materials is given, and you see the order of the coefficient of linear expansion is 10 to the power minus 5 per degree Kelvin. For aluminium, it is 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 5 degree Kelvin, like this. For brass, it is 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 Kelvin. So, from this table, it is clear that copper expand 5 times more than glass, because the expansion of glass is 0.32, and for copper it is 1.7. So you can say that copper expand 5 times more than glass. And normally you see metals expand more and have relatively high value of alpha L. You see the alpha L value for the metal, for aluminium it is 2.5, for brass it is 1.8, and for glass it is 0.32. So in comparison to glass, the metals have high value of alpha L. Similarly, you can define coefficient of area expansion, alpha A. Alpha A is equal to delta A by A into 1 by delta T, where delta A by A is the fractional change in area. Similarly, coefficient of volume expansion alpha V is equal to delta V divided by V into 1 by delta T, where delta V by V is the fractional change in volume. In this table, it is shown the volume expansion, coefficient of volume expansion, that is alpha V, for some substances in the temperature range 0 to 100 degree centigrade. In this table, you can see that Invar, which is a alloy of iron and nickel, have a low value of alpha V. The value of alpha V is 2. For Invar, it is 2 into 10 to the minus 6 Kelvin inverse. You also remember that value of alpha V for ethyl alcohol. You see, for ethyl alcohol, the value is 110 into 10 to the power minus 5 Kelvin inverse. And for mercury, the value of alpha V is 18.2 into 10 to the power minus 5 Kelvin inverse. So you should remember that value of alpha V for ethyl alcohol is more than mercury. You have to also remember that gases at ordinary temperature expands more than solids and liquids. For liquids, alpha V is relatively independent of temperature. You have to also remember this point. For liquids, the value of the volume expansion, coefficient of volume expansion alpha V is relatively independent of temperature. But for gases, alpha V depends on temperature. How alpha V depends on temperature? Suppose you take ideal gas. For ideal gas at constant pressure, this is the ideal gas equation, PV is equal to mu RT. If pressure is constant, then P into delta V will be equal to mu R into delta T. So you divide PV with P delta V. Then this will be equal to delta V divided by V will be equal to delta T divided by T. But from the definition of coefficient of volume expansion, you have delta V divided by V is equal to alpha V into delta T. But here delta V by V equal to delta T divided by T. So alpha V will be equal to 1 by T. So this clearly shows that for gases, alpha V depends on temperature. So in this video, we discussed about what is thermal expansion and how you define coefficient of linear expansion, area expansion and volume expansion. Thank you.